to introduce our work here, my talk will include two main parts. The first part is about piezoelectric nanofiber, and the second part is about a special energy generator that can generate a DC power under compression. So first see the first part. So how do I move? So I think many of you may know Euler spinning. It's a very simple but efficient way to produce nanofiber. So this picture shows a very classic Euler spinning setup. It can be very simple if you have a high voltage power supply, syringe with a needle, metal plate, you are able to produce nanofiber. So this device have many advantages and like listed here. The key is it can offer sufficient sample for fundamental study or applied research. Through this, people already found many applications of Euler spin nanofiber. The material is mainly in the form of non-woven mat. So we also found a piezoelectrical property of some Euler spin nanofiber memory. So this is our earlier finding. So initially we use a PVDF as a material to produce nanofiber non-woven mat. So the material looks like a piece of paper, but it is much softer. So on SCM, you can see nanofiber oriented randomly within the fabric mat. So if we sandwich this mat with two more metal foil, so we can get a voltage signal through compression. So each positive and negative signal come from a compression and decompression. So this result shows lots of compression and decompression cycle. That's come from a device with the working area about 4 cm². So we found this property about 10 years ago. On that time, most of the energy generator only generated a very low voltage output. So also was larger. Because PVDF is a piezoelectrical material. So in the market, we can get a commercial piezoelectrical PVDF film. So we compare our nanofiber device with the PVDF film in the same state. We found that the commercial piezoelectrical film have much smaller energy output, just 20% higher. So we also try other little spinning model like needleless spinning. We found as long as a PVDF generator, PVDF nanofiber is produced by a single polarity little spinning apparatus, it can have a piezoelectrical property. So here I should point out that although PVDF is a piezoelectrical material, its raw material doesn't contain piezoelectricity. To achieve this, in industry, people need to go to try to treat that material in different steps, including casting that into a film and then stretching along a specific direction. After that, I still need to place into high voltage electrical field for pouring treatment. So the reason for this is because PVDF have quite a few of molecular conformation. So in the solid state, people like to call them crystal faces. So here I draw the four major molecular conformation in the right image. So you can see different molecular conformation corresponding to the name of the crystal faces. The reason for the series of treatment is because the raw material only mainly contain alpha phase, which have no piezoelectricity. The piezoelectrical property come from the beta phase conformation. So that sort of treatment is to convert other crystal phases into beta phase and also make the dipole oriented in a single direction. So however, for Euler spinning, this technology doesn't need this complicated process. Just one step from solution to the solid state, it includes a high ratio of stretching and also pouring treatment in the high voltage electrofield. so which is very simple and efficient. And then the nanofiber mat also have higher piezoelectricity than a dense film. Because nanofiber is a good sound absorber, so we thought if we can combine nanofiber sound absorbing property with a piezoelectrical property, we may be able to use sound as an energy source to generate electrical power. Indeed, we achieve this by using a very simple device. We can prove that's working very well. Also, the write-up image shows a device structure we developed. It includes three layers. The middle layer is nanofiber. Two outer layer are plastic film with a layer of gold in the inner side. They are function like electrode. So the electrode have a large hole in the middle. It allow the nanofiber directly interact with the sound. So we use a simple setup to test the energy conversion property. So this include a speaker and a sound source, and also a stable stand to hold the device, and use a meter to collect the electrical signal. So these are the results from PVDF nanofiber mat. Basically, the nanofiber device mainly sensitive to low frequency of sound, up to 500 hertz. And with the increasing the intensity, the output is increased. The write-up image shows how the energy output relate to the sound pressure level. So in general, when the sound pressure level less than 90 dB, the output is relatively small. However, when the sound pressure level is higher, so you can see that with increasing the sound pressure level, the voltage increase very rapidly. So the higher sound pressure level is actually in the noise range. So the red line is the device come from commercial PVDF piezoelectrical film. So you can see, although the commercial piezoelectrical film also have some energy conversion ability, but its output is much lower. So according to this property, we thought this nanofiber device can be used either as a sound sensor or energy harvester. So the two bottom chart shows the sound sensing property. So when people say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in English, and each twice and second louder, so you can see the result like this. So if we use a mathematical method to convert that into frequency related wave function, you can see the signal from the same pronunciation have a very similar wave function, but they are different between the thus from the different pronunciations. So with the energy harvester, we actually modify the device and to draw multiple hole in the middle. So we found that multiple hole can cause multiple location vibrate intensively with the sound. So for this device, it's a size about 3 by 4 centimeter square. It can generate 14 volt voltage. So after rectification, so this voltage is sufficient to light up at least 27 LED. The energy can also be used for organic synthesis. So here we show the synthesis of polypyrrole. And we also use that for metal corrosion protection. It all works well. So not only this, we also found electric spinning is a very good technology to release the piezoelectrical potential of other polymer. So taking polyacrylnitrile as an example, so this polymer has a large dipole moment, 3.5, which is larger, much larger than PVDF. So it was predicted to have a larger piezoelectrical property than PVDF. But unfortunately, the conventional technology did not support this. So this was why PVDF always have shows higher and actually the best piezoelectrical property among the piezoelectrical polymers. However, when we use the electric spinning, we can show, we found PAN nanofiber indeed have better piezoelectrical output than PVDF. The reason for this is because PAN has two molecular conformation. One is zig-zag conformation, another is a helix. So in the raw material, this polymer mainly stand in the helix structure. The natural group actually along, oriented along the coil. So along the helix coil. So that was why the large dipole consolidates each other. So they have very small net dipole moment. However, for the electrospinning fiber, the polymer stay in the zig-zag conformation. So in this conformation, the natural group oriented in the single direction, in one direction. So that's a net overall dipole moment is larger. So we use NMR and XRD to prove this conformation in the nanofiber. So when we use a PAN to harvest the noise energy, we found it's even better than PVDF. With the same device dimension, so the PAN nanofiber device can generate a 60 volt voltage, and the bandwidth is covers not only low frequency of sound, but also the middle frequency sound up to 1000 hertz. So this device also have over double energy conversion efficiencies on PVDF nanofiber devices. So the reason for this is because PAN is nanofiber is not only have higher piezoelectrical property, it also have the better sound absorbing ability. So we are still working in this area. So this is our first part of our work. The second part is about the DC energy generator. So we also found it in our laboratory. So the work include a Schottky diode and also PN junction for seeing the earlier found. So initially we found if we use a polypyro to make a dense disk and by sandwich this disk with aluminum foil and also gold foil, under compression, the device can generate electrical power. So very interesting, this device only generate DC power. So each peak come from compression and decompression. So the voltage is around 0.7 volt. The current from disk about diameter 13 millimeter and thickness 1.44 millimeter. This PPY disk is can generate around 300 microamps output. So if we change the stream model, we found some more interesting things. So the left up one shows when the stream increase and then reduce in the same speed and repeat for many cycles, the electrical output change in a similar trend. That's voltage and the current change also increase and decrease. However, if we suddenly increase the strain and maintain the strain at a certain period of time, and after that we release the strain until the next cycle, so and repeat that, that's the voltage and the current signal change in different way. So this shows when the electrical signal reach to the highest point, it decay very slowly. This is quite different to the conventional piezoelectrical device because for the conventional piezoelectrical device, once the voltage, once the electrical energy reach to the highest value, it decay very rapidly. So if we change the sample size, device size, for example, changing working area, so the voltage output doesn't change much, but the current output change with the working area. So with increasing the working area, the current output increase. However, if we just changing the disk thickness, we still found the voltage maintain the same, but the current reduced slightly, so like this. So in literature, some paper already report PPY, polypyrrole, form a Schottky contact with aluminum, but it form a ohm contact with gold. So all device should contain single Schottky junction. So we can test this IV curve. We can find through the IV curve, we can find a rectifier effect. It comes from the Schottky junction. Under compression, the rectification rate increased. So using the classical equation, we can test, we can calculate the barrier height of this Schottky junction and found that this barrier height reduced up the compression. Also, the PPY and the compression is improved in the conductivity. So based on our experimental result, we propose a mechanism. So the basically when aluminum contact with the PPY, it's form a Schottky junction. And because of this, some electron move from the aluminum to the PPY, because PPY is a P-type semiconductor. So when the device reach to equilibrium, and if we compress the device, the barrier height reduction lead to some electron move back to the aluminum layer. So this create a electric potential between the layer because of the improved conductivity. So we can still test, get the potential between the two electrodes, aluminum and gold. So this cartoon shows the energy generation mechanism like this. So we also found not only PPY, so other conducting polymer like polyaniline, polysiphon, when they form a Schottky junction with metal, they have a similar DC power generation ability. Using polyaniline, we also understand how the ball doping pipe influence the energy generation efficiency. So by doping and de-doping a single disk, we found the doping type influenced the output. So the one with the smallest molecular size lead to the highest energy generation. So the reason for this is because the smallest dopant lead to higher improvement in the conductivity. And it also lead to a larger reduction in the barrier height during compression. So we also use graphene oxide to dope this conducting polymer and found very small content of graphene oxide can significantly improve the current output. So here is the typical result. So the PPY content 1.6% graphene oxide can improve six times improvement in the current output, will the voltage maintain the same? The reason for this is because just PPY not only reduce the internal resistance, but also leading to larger reduction in the barrier height and the compression state. So we also found if conducting polymer form a p-n junction with other semiconductor, for example, inorganic oxide. So the device all still have a DC energy generation ability. So here we use a tin oxide and PPY to form a p-n junction. So this p-n junction can generate a 0.25 volt pulse signal under compression. The mechanism is quite similar to the Schottky junctions. So more recently, we found that if we use a fabric as a substrate to get a conducting polymer coated fabric and then form a Schottky, this Schottky junction can generate a higher electrical signal under compression. So for this one, just a 2 centimeter square device, 6 to 2 centimeter fabric can generate 3.27 volt voltage. And the current is also improved. We found for the reason for this is because the device involved two levels of two energy conversion principles. One is from Schottky junction piezoelectric conversion. That's mainly from the fiber, the PPY coated fiber, which constantly contact with the aluminum layer. So another is come from the fiber, the coated fiber underneath the top layer. So this fiber, when the device compression, they have a chance to contact with the metal, aluminum metal. So that's leading to a triple electrical energy generation ability. So the key advantage of DC generator is they can group together very easily. Like a battery, if you just pay attention to the polarity, make sure the polarity in the same direction, but multiple devices can be linked either in serial and in parallel very easily. However, for the conventional energy generator, because they are generating AC pulse, AC voltage, they cannot link together in such an easy way. Because if they link in this way, some opposite signal may consolidate each other. So that's reduced the energy generation. So to link them together, each AC generator has to be linked with a rectifier. So that makes the whole device complicated and also cost more energy. So we also prove the energy generator can be used for many different purposes. For example, we can make a button-like device, then use this device for sensing forces, like a force sensor to generate electrical signal. And the signal can also be stored in capacitor, and that energy can be used to, for example, driving motors, driving electrical heater and the electrical cooler. Now, of course, we can group them together, for example, embed into shoes for harvesting working energy. So they all works well. This is our last slide, is my group or website. So if you can visit our website, you can find more details about research in this area. So all our research are teamwork, involve lots of people, student, postdoctor, and staff's contribution. It's also beyond collaboration with external research groups. So here I should thank all their great contribution to our research, and also thank the funding body from Australian government to support us. Thank you very much for your time. Thank you.